Pronouns are an important part of someone's identity. They're how a person is referred to, both directly and when being spoken of, which means it's very important that you're using the correct ones. We understand that sometimes that journey can be a little overwhelming to navigate, especially without the right tools to get you started. So that's why we've put together 5 workplace best practices around pronouns. Let's get started. Best practice number 1. Including your pronouns in your email signature or name at work where possible. Including your pronouns in your email signature or by your name at work fosters a culture of inclusivity and takes away the stigma of asking about pronouns. Not only does it make it easier for others to get to know you, it sparks conversations that you may have never been able to have before. Best practice number 2. Incorporate neutral language and greetings instead of gendered expressions like guys or ladies. When you start off a meeting or an email with verbiage like, "Hey you guys," or "Welcome ladies," it could be unintentionally hurting someone who does not identify with those gendered terms. Better expressions are, "Hey y'all," or "Welcome everyone." This way, all participants of the conversation feel safe and included. Best practice number 3. If you make a mistake and someone corrects you, say thank you instead of I'm sorry, or any other drawn-out apology. It's okay to make mistakes, but don't make others feel like they need to tell you it's okay or draw attention to it. We don't want those who we've accidentally used the wrong pronouns with to feel their identity is a burden in which they need to apologize for. Best practice number 4. Use they or their wherever possible as opposed to his or her. Non-binary people do not identify with the pronouns his or her, and it's important to be inclusive to them as well. For example, when writing a memo to employees about a new policy, employees should approach human resources with any question regarding his or her paycheck does not promote an inclusive workplace. A more inclusive way of writing this would be, employees should approach human resources with any questions regarding their paycheck. And finally, best practice number 5. Never ask about surgeries or medical status. While this one should be a given, especially in a workplace environment, it is often overlooked. You never want to put someone else in an uncomfortable or awkward position when asked about their medical status. You just don't know where someone may or may not be in their journey, and it's their decision whether they'd like to divulge that information to you. Keep in mind that everyone's journey is different, and it's okay to make mistakes. The important part is learning and growing alongside your friends and coworkers as we navigate into more diverse and inclusive work environments.